For engineering services general studies video lectures, visit www.isgeneralstudies.com. For mechanical engineering video lectures and question and answers discussion, visit www.gatemech.com.
In case of our example of dam construction, so we got a project scope. Now, in order to identify or estimate the cost and effort required to construct the dam, basically to complete the dam construction project, so we need to know how much it costs and how much time it takes. Okay, so at a higher level, when we say construct a dam, we cannot say that it will take say 3 years or 4 years, or it will take 100 crores budget or 200 crores budget as such. So for that, we need to get into the details of the dam project. So based on the location where it is, so what type of resources it needs and what is the manpower cost there. So all those factors come in only when we get into details. So work breakdown structure comes into picture in that aspect. Like, it will break down the project into detailed activities which can be defined or which can be assigned, which can be manageable, and based on which we can estimate cost and effort. So the main purpose of the breakdown, work breakdown structure, or it is also called as WPS in short form, is the purpose is to ensure all the work required to meet the project objectives is identified, defined and assigned. So when we do this activity of breaking down the project into detailed activities, we will know what all activities we are going to perform. So once we know that, we don't want to miss some components of work, some components of the project, so without identifying the entire details. So this first purpose is to ensure that all the work required is identified, so that the costing and effort, the estimates will come correct. Okay, and the second purpose is to estimate the time and cost of all these activities identified, so that we'll get the total project cost and the project effort timelines that are required. So this is the primary purpose of work breakdown structure. So in order to construct this work breakdown structure, so we use some steps, so which is a top-down approach, in order to arrive at the list of activities that we need to execute. This method establishes the logical framework for identifying the list of activities required for the project. So the main steps that are involved in determining a work breakdown structure from a project scope is like this. The first step is to identify all the major elements of the project. So in this picture, you can see the project is divided into three tasks: task 1, task 2, task 3. So when I say the major elements which define the project, so task 1, task 2, task 3, we call it say level 1. In this level, so these three tasks form the project. These three tasks, when combined, and they form the final project. So once we have the major elements, and then we break down these major elements again, task 1, task 2 and task 3, into next level of items or next level of activities. What does task 1 comprise of? What all activities are there? What does task 2 comprise of? So here in this picture, we considered subtask 1 and task 2 comprise of task 2. So this is the next major element which is consisting these two activities, subtask 1 and subtask 2. And again, subtask 2 forms three activities called work packages, work package 1, 2 and 3. So we are identifying, that is a step 2, identifying the supporting activities of the major elements. These two are supporting activities of task 2 at level 2, and these are at level 3. Work packages are at level 3, which supports the subtask 2. So, and we will be repeating this, breaking down the task at each of this level, till we reach a level where each of this work package can be, each of this activity can be assigned to an independent person and which can be manageable and which is logical. So this process is repeated until we get the activities which are logical, independent, and then manageable. Okay, and then you can see at every level, so level 1, these three tasks, task 1, task 2, task 3 will form project, as well as at level 2 also all the tasks that are there. So I didn't highlight this, like task 1 will also be having some items, some activities. Task 3 will also be having some activities at level 2. So for the illustration, I took only this task 2 activities. So at every level, when you sum up all the activities at that level, say at level 2, they will form the complete project. Similarly, at level 3, they will form the complete project. Okay. So you can see that we are following a top-down approach, that we are breaking the project into tasks and then breaking them again into subtasks. So work breakdown structure, this technique follows a top-down approach, and then it will find out the detail level work packages based on which we can estimate the time and cost of each activity. So we will discuss what this work breakdown structure finally gives us as an output. Now let us see an example on book project, how work breakdown structure is used in order to find out the activities of a book project. So you can see in the picture, book project is at the top, and it consists of the major elements, that is the research, the writing, publishing, and management. So these are the major elements that are to be looked into under a book project. So in order to planning writing and publishing a book, that is a book project objective. So in order to do that, so they will be doing some research, and then they will be doing some writing, the content of the actual book, and then the publishing part. So who will be printing, how many copies we need to print, and then proofing, all those things, and then the managing that the contents or reviewing the book contents, etc. So these are the four major elements in which they are divided, which are, you can say, largely independent. So once the writing is done, and then the publishing will happen after the management review happens. So they are managed separately with different stakeholders involved. And then the next level is to break down this part into details, what research actually means. It is basically consists of the data collection, interviews and surveys, etc. And then comes to the writing, breaking down the writing, it will be chapter wise, the research required and the initial drafts of these each chapter, and what is the front page looks like, how's the back page looks like, what are details will be there in the cover, preface. So these are the details of the actual contents of the book, which are divided into chapter wise and front related contents and back related contents. Okay, and then the publishing part will be broken down into reviews, final proofs. So this is the next level of the sub components of publishing, similarly sub components of management. So this is basically a top down approach where we are finding out the detailed activities that are to be performed, which are logical, independent, and manageable. Okay, so and then these will get combined and become the final book project. Okay, so the number of levels will change based on the project, based on the nature of the project, and the number of activities at each level also will change based on the project. So that are based on the experience or the expertise of the people involved who is developing this work breakdown structure. So once we have this detailed level activities, we will estimate what is the time and effort required of each of these activities, and then combine to arrive at the total project cost and duration. Okay, so checking the characteristics of the work breakdown structure. While performing this activity, we should be looking at the activities that there should be manageable, so it can be assigned as a single responsibility. Okay, and then the activities should be independent. There should be minimal dependency on other things, so that it can be executed separately without in the sense minimum dependency. That is minimum dependency on other activities. Okay, and then it should be integrable in the sense. So these activities, when performed individually, should get integrated easily so that we will arrive at the final project. Okay, so it is more relevant in case of software products, where one component should be compatible with the other component that is developed independently. And then it should be measurable in the sense it should be easily estimated in terms of cost and time required, and then it should be easy to track the measure the progress of the activity when while execution. So these are the main characteristics that we look when we are doing this breaking down the project work into detailed activities. So once these activities are available, we will estimate the cost and time required, and this list of activities will be passed on to the scheduling phase, where we perform the actual timing requirements for each of these activities.
For engineering services, general studies video lectures, visit www.iesgeneralstudies.com. For mechanical engineering video lectures and question and answer discussion, visit www.getnet.com.